Hello guys, and welcome back to another tutorial. Today we're going to be learning how to make a crafting table like this. Basically something that's very similar to a furnace, but uses a crafting grid rather than a an actual input and a fuel slot configuration. So without further ado, let's get into the tutorial and I'll explain how it all works. So what we first need to do is make our block. And we're going to go and call it just basic crafting table. So crafting table. And then we're going to select our side texture, our front texture, and our back texture, as well as the bottom and the top. And then what we're going to do is go click next. We're going to set the material to wood. We're going to set it into the decorations tab. We're going to set this to 2.5. And this is going to be 12.5 for the resistance. So hardness is 2.5 and resistance is 12.5. The tick rate, I would suggest keeping this at 10, just so it crafts a little bit faster than a furnace. And the next thing that we want to do is make the block header on map set to wood. So that's just a little bit further down there. And on this side, we want to make the sound on step wood. And then we're going to select our tool. So we're going to set it to an axe. And then we're going to disable the harvest level. And silk touch will be disabled. Move over to the inventory section, and then we're going to enable the inventory. We're going to set 10 slots, and we're going to disable the comparator output data, and then we're going to set slot 9 for our output slot, and then we're going to click next, and then next again, and then next again. So now we need to set up the GUI. So we're going to go to GUI, and then we're going to go and say GUI crafting table. And then we're going to create a new GUI. Then what we want to do is select our block that we just made for the block inventory. And what we want to do is enable this at the snap components on the grid. And then we're going to select our first input slot. And then we're going to put that down, let's see, 1, 2, 1, 2. So right about here. And then we're going to do this for our first 9 slots. All these will be input slots. So if you mess up on the placement like that, you can just click on the slot itself and then click the little move icon down here. And then you can move it back to the place that you need it. So we're going to set 3 and then 4 and then 5. And then we're going to set 6 and 7. And then our last input slot will be 8. And then we also need an output slot. This is going to be our 9 output, our 9 ID. So this is going to be our output slot, and that's going to go over here. We're also going to add some text, and we're going to call it crafting table, and then we're going to select the color. We're going to set the color code to 40 40 40, and this is going to set it to the default values that Minecraft uses for the text on the GUIs. So we're just going to put that right up here. Then we're going to set save, and now we can go back to the crafting table, click next, next, next until we get to the procedures. We need to do a right-click event, and then we're going to just click OK, and then we're going to go and select player procedures, and then we're going to click open GUI for provided player, and then we're going to make sure that the GUI is set to our crafting table GUI, and then we're going to go back, and then we're going to go to update tick, and then we're going to create an update tick procedure. And then we want to go to templates, and then we're going to scroll down until we see GUI template crafting table. And then what we're going to do is also just go over all this. But the first thing that we need to do is make sure we duplicate this section right here. We're going to delete this one right here. And then we're going to put that down. And then we're going to add a and statement. And I'll explain how that all works in just a second. So this looks like a lot, and it is quite a bit. Oop, I need that still. But I'll go over the best I can on how all this works, and hopefully you guys will be pros by the time this tutorial is finished. So right up here, we're testing for the 9 slot, which is also our output slot. If the output slot has not equal to 64 items, so once it reaches 64 items, it won't run this procedure anymore or test for the condition. So the other thing that's connected to this is this procedure or this condition right here, which is kind of like our main condition. So the first thing that it's going to be testing for is this cycle right here. It's going to test for if there what inventory items are in the input slots, so slots 0 to 8, and what it's going to do is basically test for the crafting grid that you set your items in. Now, you're going to be setting your recipe up here. Now, when you're placing your inventory slots, it's probably a good idea to follow the same pattern that I did. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. That way you can kind of memorize how you need it set up here. Another thing that you can do is you can put this into a line, and then put this one into a line. And then what you can do is, let's see. Maybe not, maybe it's not set up that way. So I would just try to remember that the first 3 is your top, the middle 3 is your center, and the bottom 3 is your bottom. So your top one will always be the left, your center one will always be the middle, and then your bottom one will always be your right. So that counts for all 3 sections of the grid as well. So down here, this is the other condition that is connected to it, and we made some alterations to it already, but basically what it's going to test for is if two things. So if there is 63 or less than 63 equal to or less than 63 items in the slot, and if there is a specific type of item in that slot, then what it's going to do is run the procedure down here. But if there's error, is the other option. If it's an empty inventory on slot 9 for our output slot, then it's going to basically do another procedure. So this is all targeting the output slot itself. And if one of those two conditions are true, then what's going to happen is it's going to remove all the input slot items just by one item at a time. And then what it's going to do is set an item to the output slot, slot 9, and plus 1, so it's going to add an additional slot regardless if there's one in there or not. And you're going to select your item that you want, and it's going to put it in slot 9. So to set this all up now, what we're going to do is just make some stairs. So to kind of recap on how stairs are set up, you have your first one right here, you have your second one, and then you have your third, and then you have 1, 2, and 3. So to do that, what you need to do is click on your first one. This is going to be your top left. We don't need a top middle or top bottom, so we're going to select air for these two. And then what we want to do is for slot 3 and 4 for stairs, we want to set our planks. And then we don't need slot 5, so we're going to set that to air as well. And then finally, our last three slots we're going to set to planks as well. And now for the first one right here, for the and statement and condition, what we want to do is set our stairs. And this one right down here, where it's connected to the or statement, is always going to need to be air. This is basically going to test if the inventory is empty, where this is going to be testing if the item in the output slot is specifically to a particular type of item. And then we're also going to want to make sure that it outputs that specific type of item too. And that's going to be the same as these two right here. And that's all you need to do. If you want to add another recipe, then what you would do is collapse that, duplicate it, and place it down, open it up, and change the recipe, change the type item that you're outputting, and then tell it to what kind of item to output as well. These two need to be the same, remember that. And outside of that, we can just hop in game now and test how all this works. So we're going to save that, and then we're going to let it compile. Then we're going to save again. So we're now in the world, and what we need to do is go to our decorations tab where we place the crafting table. We'll scroll down and then we'll click on this, place down our crafting table, and that's kind of the layout that we have it. You can offset the text a little bit if you need to. By the looks of it, by default it's a little bit too high. And then we're going to grab some oak planks and we're going to place them in the slots like that, and it's going to create a oak wood stairs. So if we were to do this like so, then it's going to craft up the stairs kind of like a furnace, but it's like a crafting table system. Outside of that, there isn't any way to kind of like quickly craft all these stuff up like you would with a regular crafting table. It's not that really easy to do in MCreator, and I'm not sure how to do that just yet, even if it is possible or not. But outside of that, that's the easiest way to set it all up. Now if there was, say, we'll do one of these, and if there was another item that you wanted to craft, say spruce stairs, that procedure that we tweaked in the to add the additional and statement, that would basically prevent this from being crafted and overwriting this particular block. So it's kind of an important section to update if you're going to be making a crafting table or a furnace. So outside of that, hopefully you guys found this tutorial useful. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.